Ah, seeing one of these takes me back.
Thank you. Okay, so you guys just watched the Classics demo video. So let's talk a little bit about some of the backstory of what I did, why I did it, how I did it, kind of things like that, kind of like some behind the scenes, I guess you could say. So the reasoning for Classics, I think the biggest reason was because I don't particularly like to do character recreation fonts, because I know like when the big, you know, the Obi-Wan Kenobi series came out, I knew that all the font makers were just going to do a slew of just, you know, fonts for Vader and Obi and Reva and the, you know, brother and the sister. So I was like, I'm not going to do it. I'm not gonna even going to, you know, tread in that water. I'll let them take care of that, because most font makers do a fantastic job at doing character creations. So I thought to myself, I was like, I need to put out something new. I want it to be kind of reminiscent of the old original trilogy, because if you watch the Obi-Wan Kenobi series, you can definitely hear the saber sounds are paying like an homage back to the classic sounds. If you listen to the prequels, like episode 1, 2, and 3, the saber sounds are completely different. It sounds like you're swinging like a baseball bat. It's like woof, 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 woof. And when you listen to the original trilogy, it's more subdued. It's more warmer. It's got this weird resonance to it where I call it like this phase shift, where if you put like a paper towel tube up to your ear and you listen, you hear this weird hollowness. You get this hollowness that I hear in the original trilogy, which carried into the new Obi-Wan series. And then you get the, you know, because it's back in the early 80s, you get this old, you know, analog warmth, the tube sound, the transistor sounds, all this analog warmth that was kind of missing. So I went back and I had to rewatch all the original trilogy, rewatch all of the Kenobi series, and kind of piece together this sound that would classify as a classic sound. Something that wasn't necessarily geared towards any particular character. So this is not an Obi font, it's not a Vader font, it's not anything, it's not like a Luke font. But if you listen to the original trilogy, they all carry the same classic resemblance in a saber sound, and that's what I was trying to capture. So one font to kind of rule them all, if you want a good original trilogy font, this is the one. It's kind of like a catch-all. So let's talk about some of the sounds, the individual sounds. So obviously it all starts with the ignitions, and, you know, following with that with the hum. So with the ignitions, I've noticed the original trilogy, there's the infamous snap hiss, which is more towards Luke's kind of saber sound. You get this explosively sharp, like this, like it's you hear this almost scream to it. It's like, and then you hear the hiss, like it fades out to a hiss. Now, of course, my mouth can't reproduce all that, but you guys know what I mean by the snap hiss. That's Luke's sound. Vader's sound, his is, it's a different snap hiss. It's not a snap hiss. It's more of like a muted explosive followed by like a more sizzly snake-like hiss. So what I had to do was I had to think of all these different variations of the snap hiss and kind of mold things together into one kind of unified sound. So on a lot of these ignitions, you're going to hear more of the Luke snap hiss, where it's more sharp, explosive, and bright. And then on some of them, you're going to hear it's kind of toned down to Vader's, where it's a little bit more muted, explosive, and hissy with a long trail. Now, some of the ignitions have a short trail and a long trail of hiss and different pitches. So I threw in a couple different variations of it. So each one doesn't necessarily sound like Luke, it doesn't necessarily sound like Vader, it doesn't sound like Obi, but you can hear all these elements of all three in every single ignition, so it works for any character, and that's what I was kind of going for. And ironically, if you watch the Obi-Wan series, the very final show of season one where he fights Vader for the last time, his ignition, his snap hiss was a Sith, like Vader ignition. I was like, okay, so if Obi can have a Sith ignition, why can't, you know, we incorporate that into all these ignitions. So that's what I kind of did with this. Now, the hum, very traditional. In my opinion, there's always two layers to a hum. There's the original hum line, which is the very constant hum. It's just like, it could be multiple pitches, it could be lower, like or higher. And then on top of that layer, you have what I call the buzzing or the cat purr, where it's like, so you got a hum and a purr on top of each other. Now, if you watch the original trilogy, there's different kinds of hums. Obi's hum is more constant hum, very little purr and flutter. Vader's, on the other hand, is very active, very sharp in the flutter and the purr. It's very piercing. It's like, you know, you hear all these things. So I'm trying to find different ways to incorporate all of these sounds into the hum. So it kind of modulates in and out between like a very smooth Obi, you know, very tranquil kind of hum that gradually starts to get a little buzzy, then it gets really warm and buzzy, and then it fades back into like a tranquil kind of Obi hum, and it just kind of cycles through that hum, so it captures all the characters within the hum, and it works for everything. Honestly, it's awesome. So the smooth swings and the accent swings is probably what I had the hardest time with on this font. I went through so many different variations of smooth swings, because when I listen to the original trilogy, it's a completely different smooth swing sound, and it's a completely different accent swing sound. So you get this, like I said earlier, you get this like hollowness to it. It's kind of like this, it's not like this bright buzzing, but it's very low, muted, and hollow sounded, almost like all the mids were scooped out, but the mids weren't scooped out. It just sounded very hollow, kind of like that paper tube, you know, listening through a paper tube kind of effect. You get all this comb filtering. So you get this hollowness, but again, you get this very tube-like sound, when I mean like vacuum tubes from the early 60s and 70s. And the accent swings almost had this, what I call the whoomp whoomp. So it's like whoomp, whoomp. And then you get the higher pitches like whoomp. You don't hear that in the prequel era. You don't hear that at all. It's very pretty much only in the original trilogy. And of course, they brought that back. They brought that sound back into the Obi-Wan series. So I was excited. I was like, okay, we can get, you know, a nice take on the original trilogy with some Obi-Wan sounds and kind of make a nice, massive, classic sound. Because these are all classic sounds. So the accent swings, I probably went through just days and days and days of just trying different things to, you know, get the accent swings, because I wanted it to. So if you moved it gently, you get this kind of like Obi-Wan kind of, it's almost like if you watch the Obi-Wan Kenobi series, he moves his saber slower, so you do pick up more on subtle movements, whereas the prequel era, it's pretty much all hum, or you're just full on just freaking swinging your heart out and like crazy. But the original trilogy, it's all about slower movements because their fighting style was slower. So the accent swings had to play more of a role in this, I thought. And I noticed when I built the accent swings, I had to have this like kind of vibe, because that's what you hear in the original trilogy. And then, of course, the accent swings is when it sounds a little bit more piercing, like zomp. You hear a lot of that in the accent swings. So you got to get that zomp, zomp. You got to get that in for the original trilogy. And of course, listening to the new Obi series, they brought that in. And I noticed the Obi series had elements of brightness too in it as well. So they took the classic sound and they kind of amped up the high mids and the high frequencies and made it nice and bright and modern. So I was like, okay, I got to somehow like juggle all these sounds and mold it into a package where it's cohesive enough to be called a classic sound. And I think I did a pretty damn good job at this one. I'm really stoked about this. So with the rest of the sounds are pretty, you know, I would say classic again. The clashes are very reminiscent of original trilogy, you know, Luke versus Vader. You'll definitely hear that in the classes for sure, but I made sure they were just a little bit sharper, a little bit brighter, just to give it some modern edge. The blaster blocks, however, because original trilogy, you don't hear blaster blocks. Nobody's firing, and you don't see Luke or Vader, like, you know, blaster blocking at all, unless you're watching like Rogue One. But technically, Rogue One was made, you know, in, you know, much, much, much later, as far as technology was. So it sounded different. So I had free reign to do whatever I wanted with blaster blocks. So because this was a font that was going to be used for any sort of, you know, light side, dark side, just as long as it was a classic sound, I was like, okay, so what kind of gunshots should I do? And it was like, I went through my portfolio of all these different gunshots, and I was like, well, I got rebel blasters, I've got stormtrooper blasters, I've got rifles, I've got this, I've got that. I was like, I can pretty much use anything because this font is supposed to be made for any sort of character. It could be a Luke, it could be a Vader, it could be Obi, it could be whatever you want, long as it was a classic trilogy sound. And so that's what I did. I pulled out all these different gunshot sounds. And it's like, when I do a blaster block sound, I have three layers, you know, three basic layers. There's usually more layers on top of it, but I always incorporate three basic layers. You've got your gunshot sound, which is obviously your opponent shooting at you. And that could be whatever type of rifle or blaster it is. You've got your block, which is the sound impacting the saber. And you've got what I call a ricochet, which is the laser blaster bouncing off your saber. So what's important when doing a blaster block sound, in my opinion, is you have to be aware of what I call proximity. So that means if the opponent is like right in front of you, the blaster sound obviously is going to be much louder because it's right here in front of your face. And the distance between the blast and the block is going to be much quicker. Now, as opposed to, an opponent that's maybe 20 yards away, 30, 50 yards away, the blaster block or the blast sound is going to be much softer in volume because he's so much further away. You might sprinkle in a little bit of reverb to give it some distance, but the sound is softer. The blaster block obviously is still the same volume because the proximity is going to be right here in front of you. And then, you know, the ricochet. So I kind of toyed with different blaster sounds and then different, you know, proximities. If you get, you know, close opponents, further opponents, so you're going to hear the blast sound. Some are close, some are far, but the blaster block itself, the impact will always stay constant in volume because it's happening right here in front of you, if that makes sense. So that's what I did for the blaster block sounds. And then, of course, there's force pushes. I always include at least two or three force pushes. And this one, I kind of, you know, because I got so caught up in the Obi-Wan Kenobi series, I wanted the force pushes to sound like him a little bit. So you hear a little bit of that English accent kind of, you know, pushing away. So it's a third person force push where he's grunting like, ugh! And then you hear like the force push of all this air coming out. So there's different variations of the force push in a third person. And generally, when doing force effects, I can't stand doing all these different, you know, voice lines and quotes. Because in my opinion, it's like when you purchase a font, you know, I want to give you a good saber sound. The most important thing to me is the saber sound itself. It's got to be dead accurate. It's got to sound great. It's got to swing great. It's got to feel great. It's got to be fluid. I'm not going to garbage it up. I'm not saying that people garbage it up, but like I personally don't care about voice lines. Like I'm not going to sit there and just listen to, you know, Vader talking about I'm your father. And, you know, it's like I don't care about all these voice lines. So I'm not going to include them in my fonts. I will include some force pushes in the third person to give it some immersive feeling like you're actually playing a character, so to speak, but not speaking lines. I'm not going to be, you know, throwing, you know, dumping in 20 to 30 different voice lines because, you know, you're purchasing a saber sound. You're not purchasing, you know, voice lines because I just think it's irrelevant. So I didn't do it. And then, of course, you know, the bonus track I threw in there, I actually took three, you know, different tracks and kind of blended them together, starting off with, you know, very classic original trilogy sounds, very, you know, John Williams score kind of feeling where it starts off kind of neutral, it builds into something a little bit Sithy and battle-like, and then it goes into something light side. So you have all these elements in the backing track that'll fit for any character. And again, so that was the purpose of this font, was to build something that would be suitable for any character. whether if it's a character recreation like Luke or Vader or Obi, or it could just be your own character that you have in your head. Long as you want the original trilogy sound, that's what this is going to give you. It's not going to model anybody in particular, but it will give you that original, you know, classic trilogy sound that people have grown up to love and adore. And that's what this font's going to deliver. So with that being said, thank you for watching the demo video and enjoy the font.